Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. One of the biggest hate groups in this country, I have said for years, is called the Southern Poverty Law Center. If there is such a thing as a hate group, then the Southern Poverty Law Center is a hate group. It just shoots out mendacity and hatred with hundreds of millions of dollars at its disposal. It is one of those groups about which one can say America is a worse country because it exists. But what they do is theoretically, their theory is, to expose the hate of the right. What they do is they hate the right. That's what they do. They hate the right. The latest proof that this is a hate group that lies is this. This is astonishing. This is from the Daily Caller. And you can check it up at the Southern Poverty Law Center website if you wish to. Now, remember the Orlando nightclub shooting? The ISIS-inspired attack that left 49 people dead? Now, everybody understands that he was animated by Islamic radicalism. Is that correct? Everybody understands that. But not the SPLC, the Southern Poverty Law Center. They have no interest in Islamic terror. They have interest in the right. They have actually declared this to be a right-wing plot. The Islamist murders of 49 people at the gay nightclub was a right-wing plot. So, according to the Southern Poverty Law Center, are the shootings of police officers by anti-white terrorists. They are also a right-wing plot. I continue to read. Matin, that is the guy, remember, Omar Mir Sadiq Matin. He was the perpetrator of the June Orlando gay club shooting. Matin pledged allegiance to the Islamic State before he died and was on the FBI's radar as an Islamist sympathizer before the attack. Yet the Southern Poverty Law Center, which exists only to defame the right, that is its only raison d'etre, it has no interest in hate except for creating more, declares Matin to be a right-wing extremist, not an Islamist. The Orlando shooter is one of two Islamic extremists on the Southern Poverty Law Center's list of right-wing terrorists and plots. The other is Luqman Amin Abdullah, a Michigan imam killed by the FBI in a 2009 shootout. Federal court documents described him as a Muslim separatist. The group did not offer an explanation to the Daily Caller about why Abdullah and Matin are considered right-wing terrorists. Now I go on with the Southern Poverty Law Center, which, by the way, is quoted by every liberal newspaper, which is almost redundant, as if it is an authority and not a far left. It's the alt-left. The SPLC is the alt-left. If there is an alt-right, there's an alt-left. This is the alt-left. But they not only don't say it's alt-left, they don't say it's left, they don't say it's progressive, and they don't even say it's liberal. They just cite it as if it is a fair source. The Southern Poverty Law Center did not explain to the Daily Caller why two black power-supporting cop killers are considered right-wing. Isn't that amazing? Cop-killing, anti-cop, anti-white, black extremists are considered right-wing. Micah Xavier Johnson is responsible for the July ambush of police officers in Dallas. Remember that massacre of police officers? 5 dead, 7 wounded? Dallas police said that Johnson told them he wanted to kill white people, and a picture from his Facebook profile shows him holding up a black power fist. The other one is Gavin Eugene Long. He killed 3 Baton Rouge police officers in July. He claimed in YouTube videos that he was a former member of the Nation of Islam, which believes white people were created by an evil scientist named Yacoub. And these two are listed by the Southern Poverty Law Center as right-wing extremists. Next time you ever see or read anything citing them, you will know it is probably false.